welcome all of you. It's a surprise because I was expecting that I would be called in the next session. For 5 minutes is just very difficult, and as a historian, I wanted to bring out certain facts about Islam and Muslims in Indian history. But nonetheless, I just try to give a summary. What I want to say precisely that after these 70 years of independence, if a community still faces a lot of allegation and still living with a lot of past dark fantasies of being the responsible for partition of India, it is something a shame for the country, not for the community. Because first we have to understand that why we need to work on our image as a community, because image is something which is a reflection of your past and which is a window for your future. And we must work to correct our past, not correct because we are supposed to basically bring the correct representation of past, because most of the history which had been written long back after partition or during the imperial time was basically agenda based. For example, if you are reading Ishwari Prasad, K.S. Lal and Jagannath Sarkar, so precisely you are going to blame the Muslim community for everything which is wrong in this country, right? So, but if you are reading the correct research book, for example, if you have basic books like Satish Chandra, if you are reading, then you will be able to understand the real image of Muslim community in India. Muslims live in this country for 1,000 years, and that is true with peace and coexistence. Muslim community and Islam didn't bring even a single regressive policies, attitude, of culture, tradition in this country. If somebody says, for example, people say that in Islam you get the freedom to have 4 wives, just make them remind, if somebody ever asks you that why is it so, that polygamy, which was something very popular already in India, Islam didn't bring the polygamy in India. Secondly, if somebody says you, for example, people say that the population of Muslim is growing very fast, basically it's an agenda by certain media groups because they want to bring and to sustain the negative image of Muslim community. If you go to the 2nd September 2015 Indian Express newspaper, you can go through the details that the population of Muslim is not growing very fast in comparison of Hindu. And I'm not making comparison because Hindu is the largest community and Muslim is the second one. But if you randomly pick up 1,000 people and 1,000 families, then you can make a comparison. Then you all of a sudden and you see that Muslims have been accused a lot because of Sultanate period and Mughal period, because the Indian historians, I mean a couple sets of historians blame that they entered in India because they had actually imperialistic approach, that they wanted to rule the territory. But that is not the reality, because Islam entered in India long back in 7th century in South India basically, and they came in India as traders, they came in India as artisans, they came as a commerce people, and they settled in India rather. They were not like Britishers, because Britishers were the looters who damaged this country, who wrote the history, who created all the myths. And it is because of the evil politicians and political parties of India, the media people, they are still carrying out those evils and relating those evils with the Muslim community. But if I say precisely in last, I mean like a concluding remarks, it would be that Muslims who introduced the syncretic culture to India, because Sufis came in India, and Bhakti movement, if somebody gives the credit to Bhakti movement started in 7th century, but they collapsed thoroughly in the southern India. They revived their movement again after the establishment of Sufis basically, because they took a lot of inspiration from the Sufi movement. So Sufis were the people who came in India, they introduced the syncretic culture, and Islam has been the kind of religion who always believed in adoption and adaptation, because these are two different things. Islam never been such a rigid religion that if you see there's a lot of cultural diversity between a North Indian Muslim and a South Indian Muslim. And this is give a kind of, you know, impression that how Islam entered in the entire subcontinent, and they literally assimilated themselves into the local culture. So if calling a religion who has been such adaptive and adopted a rigid religion is would be totally wrong. Last 3-4 lines before giving me the speech, I would like to say that What we need to do, I mean, if you are from law department, if you are from any discipline, respective disciplines, keep your discipline on your first priority, but do read the history of India, because if you do not understand your correct past, you will never be present the correct future of Muslim community. You have to come to that platform that you can argue with the people. Actually, if somebody tells you that Muslims who actually looted India, then you can actually make the point that you have to prove that if Mughals generated certain tax, did they actually transfer into Central Asia? No. They invested all the money into this country. They were not like Britishers rather, right? And apart from this, you see, they've given a lot of money to this country in terms of arts and culture and music and education and science. What not the actually their contribution in Indian society? And if somebody calls that Muslims is it's a three things basically. Muslims are illiberal, Muslims are intolerant, and Muslims are uneducated. Then you must actually point out the issue that Muslims are not basically like this. Muslims have been put this way by the public, by the politicians, by the media, and by the historians who were writing the history behind a very hardcore agenda. Thank you very much.